You know, I've always said that I would have to be forced to change, forced to grow up, that without this force, I would remain a dependent child forever. I thought leaving would do it, like going to Tennessee, and in a sense, it did. I started washing clothes, doing dishes, homework on time, and even going to bed at a reasonable hour. But that wasn't permanent, because without fail, every break, no matter the season, I had to come home and you're back doing everything for me. And I'm existing without a care. Though, to be honest, I wasn't that responsible in Tennessee. I acted like a little rich girl and had mommy's bank account to fall back on. No, a change in state wasn't going to do it. It wasn't going to make me grow up. It had to be you. Distance was needed. We knew that, which is why I was going to live in the dorms. But I guess that wasn't a big enough compromise or change. Because in a blink of an eye, you died. With no warning, no prep. Just a week of you being tired and nauseous. If this is what I needed to finally grow up, I think I would have preferred we try it the distance first. Like you still alive, and we just live apart. But I guess 2 years in Tennessee was living apart, and it didn't work. I was still a girl, stuck in the pain of her youth, refusing to deal with my emotions, or rather, scared to. It's crazy, because one of the deciding factors or questions for me moving back here was, do I want to be a kid for 2 more years, unworried about reality, or do I want to face it and grow up? And I decided that a semester of fun was enough, that I was ready for reality / adulthood. Then you died, and I was like, I take it back. This is not what I meant. Now that I think about it, a part of me, like the smallest fraction of a part, felt like I had done it. Like if I had stayed at TSU, you'd still be alive. That in wanting to be an adult, I killed you. Which is ridiculous, but I've always had an interesting process of thought.
My earliest memory of my mom was when I was a toddler. I was like 3 or 4. We had just got McDonald's and we were at home eating, and she had the tenders with the buffalo sauce and I had the nuggets with the barbecue. Naturally, I wanted what she had, so she let me taste her sauce and tenders, and that's how I fell in love with spicy things. It sounds like a non-event, but it was the first of many special memories I had with my mom. Such as all the vacations we went on, that from an outside looking in perspective seemed like a parent taking their spoiled kid to an amusement park, but they were just as much for her as they were for me. It was both of us who wanted pictures with the characters. To be fair, though, my mom took pictures of everything, especially me. I was like her favorite thing to capture. There are pictures of me watching TV, pictures of me playing video games, pictures of me eating, and pictures of me sleeping, and pictures of me trying on clothes on top of the typical first days, birthdays, and recital days. She loved pictures. I took them of everything. A trait I inherited. Unfortunately, I didn't take that many of her. My mom and I are very similar, more than I would admit as a child. We're both giant nerds who love movies. We'd go to the movies every week and would often see 2 movies each week. We also love shopping or just randomly going to the store. Our favorite places, second to the movies, was the mall. We'd buy things I didn't need and then eat in the food court. Again, me taking her food. My mom had good taste in food. We'd randomly go to restaurants a lot. Chili's was a frequent of ours when I was a teenager. Thank God I expanded my palate before she left. I remember in my earlier years, she'd be annoyed because all I'd eat was pizza and chicken tenders. And now I can go months without either. Hi, Mom. There are many things I want to say. I'll start with the simple. I'm fat, and I don't like it. My clothes don't fit, and I wish you were here to make me buy new ones. Several thousand movies have come out, and I wish you were here to watch them with me. I see your car a lot, especially as of recently. And sometimes when I see it, I just want to honk and have you turn around and wave. Call and ask where I'm going. And for me to tell you, I'll see you at home and that I love you. I love you. Now for a big thing. I'm sure you probably noticed that I've been living as a man. I hope you don't hate that or hate me. Please give me a sign that you don't hate me. I'm grown now. Like, I feel like an adult. I do everything for myself now. And that's fun. Is it possible to go back on stages of grief? You've been gone for nearly 2 years, and desperately I want to hear your voice. Hear you respond. Tell me anything. Show me a meme. Tell me about your day. Or watch TV with you. I'm sorry for not listening when you were here. Pushing you away all those times. This isn't an excuse, but I push a lot of people away. I still do. I really miss you. And I actively try not to think about the fact that you're not here. Because it hurts. It hurts so much that you're not here. And I want your hugs. I want you to tell me everything's okay. That I'm okay. That you still love me. Because I don't know if you do. And that hurts. Before it was like, if I act like you and do what you did, then I'd know you'd love me. Or before that, vilifying you so I could be okay that you're not here. But that didn't work because it still hurts that you aren't here and I'm not you, that you're disappointed in me, or that you hate me now, that I'm becoming myself. I really hope you don't hate me. And if you do, I'm sorry. I'm sorry and I love you. I love you so much and I miss you.